Hi everyone, today we are going to study the last part of this lesson and it will be related with assisted reproductive techniques, birth control methods, sexually transmitted diseases, and gender-based violence. We are going to start with assisted reproductive techniques. First of all, we need to distinguish these two concepts. Okay, it's not the same sterility as infertility. Sterility is the inability to have children, and infertility is the inability to have children naturally. Okay, people who suffer from sterility is not going to have children in any way. Okay, that is caused because those people maybe have anomalous gametes, okay, or anomalous sexual organs. And obviously reproduction is not going to be, is not going to happen in these cases. But infertility is the inability to have children naturally, okay, in a natural way. But we can use assisted reproductive techniques for solving infertility problems. Infertility problems are in general caused by hormones alteration, okay, an obstruction of reproductive tracts, both can be male or female, okay, either male or female, a low sperm count, and incompatibility of sperm with vaginal mucus. So when we have some of these problems, we can solve it with these two techniques: artificial insemination or in vitro fertilization, which are not the same, and we are going to see the difference now. So the first technique is artificial insemination. This technique is generally used when there's a low count of sperm, okay, but not really, really low, okay? If it's really, really low, we need to use in vitro fertilization. In this case, when there's a low count or when there's problems with hormones, women can be treated with a hormone treatment, okay? And sperm is going to be during the ovulation, okay, the day of the ovulation. Obviously doctors control the ovulation cycle, okay, and the day of the ovulation the sperm is put inside the uterus, and that's all, okay. This is the least invasive methods. They insert the sperm directly into the uterus. This is more effective than the natural, the copulation, okay? Because copulation occurs in the vagina, not in the uterus. So it's more probable that sperm can reach the ovules in the tract, okay? And so this is artificial insemination. I think it's clear, okay? It's not so difficult to understand this. It's to put sperm inside the uterus. And now we are going to see the we are going to see the in vitro fertilization. The other technique that can be used is the in vitro fertilization. What's going to happen here? This is used generally when there's a really, really, really low count of sperm, okay? Or when the woman has some problems or hormone problems and ovulation doesn't occur in a normal way. So, first of all, the woman is going to be under a treatment of hormones. For what? For producing several ovules. You know that a woman produces an ovum per month, okay? But in this case, first, a hormonal treatment, okay? For producing several ovums, and in the ovary, four or five several follicles are going to develop instead to produce several ovums. In this case, I'm going to put four, okay? Second, these ovums are going to be extracted with a syringe from the ovary, okay? They are going to be extracted. They are going to be taken out and put into a vitro. That's the name, in vitro, okay? Into a glass. Vitro is the same as glass. Okay. Second step, third step. The sperm of the partner, okay, is going to be taken in a natural way, okay? Not with a punction, with a natural way. Sperm is going to be taken and mix with the ovules. And here we have the ovules with the sperm, okay? Third step, this a fourth step, sorry. Ovules are going to be fertilized with this sperm. Take into account that if the sperm count is really low, it's impossible that they reach the ovum in a natural way. Okay? But in this case, you are just joining the ovules with the sperm count, with the spermatozoans, okay? They are here. Okay, and they are going to fertilize these ovules. What is going to happen after this? The fourth step, fertilization occurs, okay? And now what we have are the zygotes. Four zygotes, I'm going to put it like this, okay? These zygotes are going to grow and form an embryo. Okay, they are going to divide, cells start dividing, its zygote starts dividing, okay, and they divide more, okay, till they form the morula, and after this, these embryos, okay, this is the five, well, it could be fourth fertilization. The five is the develop of the embryos, okay? Develop of the embryos. And lastly, these embryos are going to be placed into the uterus, okay? Here, in this case, there are going to be more chances that the pregnancy occurs, okay? And this is more or less all the technique. Ovules are extracted, they are fertilized with a sperm, embryos develop, and we put the embryos in the uterus, okay, waiting for the implantation. Sometimes they put several embryos, okay, because not all of them get attached to the uterus wall, okay? There's not always there's an implantation of the embryos, and that's all about the technique. Okay, but now I can tell you something interesting, but not really good. Okay, when we have,
well, not really good.
In Spain, for example, it is prohibited to do what I'm going to tell you now. But in another countries, it is allowed. I can tell, I want to have a baby, but I want to have a girl, not a boy. Okay, you do this. You have here 4 embryos, okay? And you can choose one. You can take and you can analyze each embryo. You can analyze their DNA, okay? And you can check if they are male or female. And if you want only females, you can put the female in the uterus. That's not really good, because it's like you are choosing, discarding other ones. But it could be used in a right way, okay, for helping people with genetic diseases. For example, imagine that I suffer from a genetic disease and I want to have a baby, but I don't want the baby has that genetic disease. So if I do this here, we can analyze the embryos and check which one is not suffering from that genetic disease. And I can say, oh, this one is not suffering from the genetic disease, so this one can be put here, but these other ones suffer from the genetic disease and they are not going to be placed here. And so this is all about the reproduction, assisted reproduction techniques. Now we are going to birth control methods. So as you can see, there are several birth control methods, and now we are going to learn what consists on each method. As you can see, first of all, we have natural methods, okay? I want you to know, in general, well, I'm going to tell you later this. Natural methods, okay, are the calendar or symptoms-based methods, for example, the Ogino methods. This just is based in control. You control the calendar or the symptoms of ovulation, and you can predict, okay, not really accurately, okay, you can predict when you are not ovulating or ovulating, okay? This is not a good method, because as you know, ovulation can be delayed or can happen before the time expected, okay? And also you know that a sperm can live a few days in the fallopian tubes waiting for ovulation. So these methods are used for get pregnant, okay, but not for avoiding. If you want to get pregnant, you can more or less guess when you are ovulating, and you can practice sexual habits without barriers, okay? But this method is more used for get pregnant, not for avoiding, okay? The other method is the coitus interruptus. This consists on stop practicing the sexuality, okay, or the penetration, stop the penetration before ejaculation occurs. What is going to happen with this one? It is not so, it's a bit risky, because as you know, there's a preseminal fluid, okay, that can contain spermatozoans, and it is released before ejaculation. So this method is not really good. Then we have the barrier methods. These ones are more effective than these ones. We have the condom. Condom can be either male condom or female condom. Male condom covers the penis, okay? And female condom can be placed inside the vagina. It's more or less like a male condom, okay? And can be placed inside the vagina. It's a barrier, okay? These condoms, either male or female, are the only ones that prevent from sexual diseases, okay? Are the only ones that prevent from sexual diseases, because there's no a direct contact between the penis and the vagina. The other one is the diaphragm. Diaphragm is a device that is placed in the neck of the uterus, okay? This is the vagina, this is the uterus, and diaphragm is placed here. And it avoids that sperm reaches the uterus. But this method is not really used, and it is more safe, okay, using condoms. Then we have the intrauterine device. In Spanish is DIU, okay? That is a device that is placed by a doctor, okay? This method, you have to look for a doctor for using this method, okay? The doctor is going to place a device inside the uterus, okay? Like a T, for example, okay? The doctor places this, and this stays for several years, okay? It stays for several years, and what this does is avoids that the sperm is going to reach the ovules, okay? Ovules are going to be fertilized. They are going to be fertilized, but when the fertilized ovule or zygote reaches the uterus, this avoids the implantation. So it's going to fall down, okay? This device avoids the implantation of the zygote in the intrauterine device. Next ones are chemicals, okay? These ones are really effective. These ones, the hormone treatments. But this one, not. Hormone treatments avoid ovulation of the woman. So a woman that is taking pills is using a vaginal ring or patches that release hormones, okay? The vaginal ring, the woman have to place it inside the vagina, a vaginal ring, during the ovulation cycle, okay? And then when menstruation is going to come, you took out that vaginal ring, and when menstruation finishes, you put another one, okay? But this has to be prescribed by a doctor, okay? All of them have to be prescribed by a doctor. And prescribed, okay? In this case, the doctor is the one who places this and lasts for years. These ones, the doctor only prescribes, and you use the method. They prevent pregnancy in a best way that this one, okay? They are really good for preventing pregnancy that this one. They are better than condoms. But what is the problem? That this, they don't prevent from sexual diseases, okay? Because there's no barrier. The other ones are spermicides. Spermicides are chemical substances that are placed inside the vagina, okay, before copulation. What is going to happen? They kill sperm, okay? But they are not really safe, okay? They are not accurate. And mainly people use spermicides. Well, people, in fact,
don't really use spermicides, okay? But people who use spermicides, use in combination with condoms, okay? You can wear a condom and then place a spermicide inside the vagina, because if the condom breaks, there will be a there will be more less chances to get pregnant. But the spermicides are not a good method, okay? Not good method. Then we have the surgical methods, which are the tubal ligation or the vasectomy. These ones consist on cutting the sexual tracts, okay? The fallopian tubes, or the tracts that goes from the testes to the penis, okay, by a vasectomy. They are cut and tied. So spermatozoans are not going to release with the sperm, okay? And ovums, if you cut this, obviously, and then you tie here, ovums are not going to pass through here. The same with vasectomy. Ejaculation occurs during vasectomy because, as you know, we have the testes, the conducts that go to the urethra, but here are the glands, okay? The glands that produce sperm. But the spermatozoans, if you cut here and here, okay, and you tie it, spermatozoans are not going to pass through here, but this gland, for example, prostate, is going to produce an ejaculation, obviously, okay? And more or less, this is all. But I want you to tell another two methods. Okay, the last methods are the pill of the day after, okay, and the abortion. I'm going to put you two examples. Imagine you are having sexual habits, and when you finish, you notice that the condom has broken. Fail. Oh my god. So what could you do? You can take the day after pill. There is a day after pill and even a 5 days after pill, okay? If you take that pill, you are going to prevent the pregnancy. If you don't take it, you're not preventing, obviously. But if this fails, okay, or if you don't do this, you have another chance for preventing pregnancy, which is abortion. This is your last chance in the first months. But abortion is a really harmful technique, okay? You have to kill the embryo, and after killing it, it has to be sacked, okay? It's a technique which is called ligrate. It has to be sacked from the uterus, and that's really harmful. It's harmful, physically harmful, and also psychologically harmful. So, you have to take into account that you have to wear condoms for preventing pregnancy and for preventing sexual diseases. If this fails, you can use the day after pill. And this usually never fails, okay? It usually never fails. And if this fails, you can practice an abortion, but I don't recommend you these ones. So take care in the previous steps. And so this is all about birth control methods, okay? And now we are going to see some diseases, and lastly we are going to see the gender-based violence. So now, as you know, for avoiding all these diseases, okay, you have to use condom, either male or female, and it's the only method for avoiding this. We have three kinds of diseases: caused by bacteria, caused by viruses, or caused by fungi. Okay. First one, bacterial, syphilis and gonorrhea. This causes infections, okay, in our genital systems, and they can be treated, okay, with antibiotics. Don't think that this is a piece of cake, okay? Sometimes when you suffer from syphilis, you don't notice till the disease is really advanced, okay? And it causes serious problems in nervous system. So, because I don't want you to think that if I suffer from this, I'm going to take antibiotics. No, if you suffer from syphilis, maybe you are going to suffer it and you don't notice till the disease is really advanced, okay? And you can take antibiotics but the damage that this bacteria has produced in your nervous system is not going to be repaired, okay? And then we have the viral diseases. First one, genital herpes. This one causes warts, okay? It's like an herpes, and it was warts, verrugas. There's no treatment, okay, for herpes, as like the labial herpes is more or less the same. It's not the same virus, okay, but it's more or less the same. And when you suffer for first time, maybe the herpes disappears, but it can appear in once again after several, in even years, okay? Because the virus is going to stay in your body, and it can wake up in any moment, okay? Papilloma viruses also causes warts, okay? Not always. And papilloma can result in a uterus cancer. This one can cause uterus or uterine cancer. Nowadays in Spain, all women when they are 14 years old, okay, they take the vaccine for papilloma. So if they are not going to suffer papilloma, so they are not going to suffer uterine cancer. In the case of males, okay, if the papilloma doesn't provoke any cancer in males, okay, but in females, it causes uterine cancer, but we prevent it with the vaccine. Next one, hepatitis. Hepatitis C, okay? B and C. B and C. There are three kinds of hepatitis, A, B, and C. Hepatitis A also is transmitted by the viruses. The virus is transmitted by food, okay? By meals. But B and C are sexual transmitted. These ones causes several diseases in the liver, okay, and they are chronic. There's a treatment for them, okay, there are treatments, but they are chronic and they can have a lot of complications. And last one is the HIV, which produce AIDS. In Spanish is VIH, el virus, y la enfermedad SIDA. HIV is human immunodeficiency virus, okay? And AIDS is acquired immunodeficiency syndrome. This virus kills our defenses, okay? It kills our defenses. So when you are suffering from this virus, you are not going to have defenses. And you can die of a cough. A simple cough can kill you. Nowadays, there's a treatment for these ones, okay? They are chronic. They last for the rest of your lives, okay? They are chronic. And the problem, when you are suffering from this at the beginning, you don't know you are suffering from it. And you can infect other people. That's the problem. It's just like coronavirus. When you are suffering from it at the beginning, you don't know it and you can infect other people. In the 80s and 90s, a lot of people, millions of people died of this disease. Nowadays, it's chronic, but it can result into complications and low levels of your defenses, which is not recommendable to suffer. Okay. And last one, the fungal diseases. The most common case is candidiasis. Okay, this is a fungus. Okay, which can grow in the vagina. This is related. It's easy. Okay, you have to take an antifungal pills or antifungal gel. Okay. And it's going to be killed. This usually occurs because of a low level of the vaginal flora. Yep. Flora. You know that we have the intestinal flora, okay? And also vaginal flora. That flora, that bacteria, kill another microorganisms, okay? So they protect us as the skin flora also. They protect us. What happens? Sometimes this vaginal flora can be under a low level, and this can result in suffering a fungal disease as candidiasis. This does not have to be transmitted in a sexual way, okay? It usually appears when the vaginal flora is under low levels, okay? Candidiasis usually appear. And so this is all. Remember, condoms, always, okay? Always. And now I'm going to talk to you about the gender-based violence, okay? You are going to do an activity with the speaking assistants about this, okay, and also about gender violence. I want you to take into account, okay, that gender violence can be either from male to female or from female to female, okay? And I want you to remember one thing: you are free. You are free, and nobody can control you. Nobody can control you. You can do whatever you want if you are not hurting somebody, okay? So, if you want to be with your friends, if you want to chat by your mobile phone, or if you want to do some things that you usually do, okay, nobody can tell you that you shouldn't do that, okay? And even the problem is from the person that suffers from violence and don't tell it, okay, to no one. And the problem is from the person who is committing that violence, okay? Person who commits violence, person, yellows person, okay? There are persons which are yellows. Those persons have a problem, okay? And in this case, if you have a problem, you have to search for help. If your partner or if your mate is controlling you, you are having a problem, okay? And you should look for help. But the other person, the jealous person, have a problem and should look for help. And take this into account, okay? And you are going to work about that with the speaking assistant. So, see you next class, and this is all. I hope you've learned a lot today.